Welcome back once again, guildmates. Oh, that's right. I had to sit forward so that you guys can clearly hear me and my mic audio. Apparently, my mic picks up a lot of background, or at least you guys are hearing a lot of background. Which is funny because, okay, the gain is turned down lower. There we go. I got a good amount of gain right now. I'm really close to the mic. So hopefully you'll be able to check out all the stuff that I'm doing and talking about relatively easily. Really quickly, I want to apologize for the lateness of the episodes being put out today. I've spent over 12 hours working on episodes, and that was mostly because I didn't pay enough attention to the fact that I had the desktop audio muted on OBS when I was recording these. So episode 16, 17, and half of 18, there was no audio for the actual episode. 19 was fine. Obviously, 20 is going to be fine because I've got it. I'm double and triple checking everything to make sure I'm good. I do have my webcam audio muted. I'm just going through the Yeti headset, or the Yeti, and I've got the headset on through the Yeti. Like, the sound comes through the Yeti for me, but it still has to be picked up through desktop audio on OBS. So that's what happened there. But we should resume our natural stuff, which basically means as soon as I record this, the raw file that I have, which is, it records in FLV just to make sure that everything is good. And then I convert it to MP4, which takes a couple of minutes. It's not very long. And then that version that just gets converted to MP4 is ready for Patreon. That's all I have to do for Patreon videos. Like, 2 minutes, and we're ready to put the full episode up on Patreon. And then I have to take and put that onto this little thumb drive right here. And I put it on my other computer, my other laptop, and I drag it and drop it into Windows Movie Maker with the intro. And then I start chopping it up so that it's safe for YouTube. And I'm sorry, guys, you're not going to get very much of the episode. Any parts that I'm not talking over or leading up to me talking over about something, I can't show. So the more I talk during an episode, the more I could actually show. But that's why episode 18 is just 6 minutes and something for the video. Like, it's really, really short. And why most of my videos are like 12 minutes. Or, you know, if I don't do like an actual outro for the episode, generally that means that I don't actually have a very long video. Honestly, that's just... Sorry, guys. I'm not actually tired. I woke up really late. I woke up at like 1 in the afternoon because I was up till about 6 in the morning trying to make sure that episodes were done. But once I got the audio synced up and everything, because I had to take episodes and turn them into MP3s so that I had the audio, sync them up, and like cut out bits where I'd skip forward and stuff like that, or to skip the intro and all that jazz. But once I did that, then I more or less had everything good to go. And then I rendered them. I updated the links. So hopefully the links on Patreon work. By the time you're seeing this on YouTube, which should be tomorrow, if things go well, you wouldn't have noticed any of this. Like, I got that stuff out way before anything even started editing for YouTube. I was in the process of editing for YouTube when I discovered this, and I was like, wait, where's the sound? And so I had to immediately go back and put the sound in on Patreon. So it took a lot longer for the Patreon videos than it should have. And so, yeah. But if everything works right and everything goes right, I will be working on... I'll be recording episode 20 of Haikyu today, and then it's going to be My Hero Academia episodes for the rest of the time that I'm going to be recording. And then tomorrow, because I'm already a week behind, so I might as well just make a full day out of it. It's going to be just manga dubs, like nothing but manga dubs, back to back to back to back to back to back. I've got 2 chapters of just about everything, so I got a lot to go through. And I've got all of that set up, and I'll have everything sitting right here. Pardon me. I'll have everything sitting right here in front of me, and that will make things so much easier. I don't know how it looks for you, but for me, watching it here in studio mode or whatever, what have you, it looks very clean. It looks very crisp. I like how it looks right now, but I can't be 100% sure that it's going to continue looking that way as the video edits. Because as I was going through and checking out the videos, I was like, oh man, the quality doesn't look so crisp and clean. So I don't know. Maybe it could be converting over, but honestly, I do need a better webcam. So that could also be part of it. All right. That being said, I've said a lot of stuff that doesn't really have a lot to do with much of anything. So that doesn't have much to do with this episode. Let's jump right into episode 20 of Haikyu, which is Oikawa Toru is Not a Genius. Yay, Sugu! Suga's coming in. Oh, okay. It does look grainy, so it is the camera. Okay. Yeah, so I need to get a better camera next. Cool. Hey. Yeah. I love Suga's interest. He's just yes. Yes, I love it. It's great. It's absolutely awesome. And guys, I am going to be this close to the mic from now on so I can be heard very clearly. I was born with this face. It's not my fault. Be right back. No. It did not have to hear it from him. That's the worst part for him. It's like he's getting scolded by Hinata. It could not possibly be worse than that. Suga's the only one who can tell Daichi what to do. I love that. I like that you call him Mr. Refreshing. That's kind of cool. I like that nickname for Suga. Mr. Refreshing should just be his nickname forever. This really well planned. I love that Suga gets Hinata, like, gives him advice, and so now he gets better at blocking. Yeah, I am trying to write stuff down for the end, so yeah, I apologize to YouTube viewers for the amount of content I have to cut out, but unfortunately, can you do? Toho has come after me quite a few times, as you can tell. So, yeah, there we go. I'm gonna turn the mic volume down just a little bit because... Okay, there we go. Nice. I'm looking at the sound bars right now, and just talking naturally doesn't go into the red anymore, so that's good. Hey. I love all the high fives that they're giving each other. It's just, he really is. Oikawa had it right. He absolutely is Mr. Refreshing. Not just for the team, but for the audience as well, because Tobio is super, super intense. And then you get Suga, who's very, very refreshing. And just a necessary thing right there, man. Even the one who's moving on instinct is now thinking, yeah, exactly. Hinata grew a brain! What? What is this nonsense? That look and the glowing eyes. Oh, it's on, baby. It is on. All right, time to take the set, boys. Lucky. Aw, poor Daichi. We never get to see his spike. But we see him angry. You'll see when Oikawa's serve comes up. I love this comparison that they're doing between him and Suga. Hey, Chikara! Chikara, Inosta Chikara. The dawn of the second years, as Sayako-nesan put it. I really feel bad that Inosta doesn't get a lot of attention because he's such a good character, but even, like, you know, the B characters in this show get a lot of really good character development. I love that. Between the two of them. The interactions between Hinata and Kageyama are, like, so hilarious. Just freaking hilarious. They really are. Of course it's Tanaka! Domo! Nice! I love how we get... I love everybody's reaction to that! Yeah! Oh, screw it, Daichi! Daichi's got your number! Damn. Listen to this intensity, and this is all going in. All of this is taking place in just milliseconds. Holy crap, that's... Imagine processing information that quickly. Like, I can. But can everybody else do that? That's the beautiful thing about being ADHD, is I process information very quickly. Jesus, this is such an amazing scene! I just love the dichotomy going on here between Suga and Kageyama. Like, the two of them acting the way that they are. Asahi sounded like a badass. That's awesome. Give it to me. I'll do it. Yeah. If you're gonna stop Suga, you better bring an iron. If you're gonna stop Asahi, you better bring an iron wall. Oh, this music gets me so much. It gets me so good, man. Ah! Love it. Love it. I love Hinata's expression right here. So many of Hinata's expressions when they're kind of talking about him are adorable. Like, Hinata's my third favorite. Obviously, because I have the same kind of hair, or lack of. Whee! And to jump over and to... Alright, let's transition over real quick. And, ah, there it is. There's the stuff I wrote down. Also, really quickly, just so I can have peace of mind. I'm about 75% sure. Nope! That was episode 21, Senpai's True Abilities. So I was on the wrong episode. Oops. So, things that I'm going to talk about for episode 21. And then I'll just go to recording episode 20 right after this. Can't believe I recorded the wrong one. Oikawa Toru. Yeah, Oikawa Toru is not a genius. I just clicked on the wrong one. Wow. How did I manage to do that? Or did it skip ahead for some reason? Yeah, okay. So, I'll be reacting to that. But see, it's got it at 7 seconds in. All right, so now I'm at zero. Okay, I don't know what I did, but somehow I managed to skip ahead on that one. I don't know how that happened, but we'll react to episode 20 and do it this way. So 21 is just going to have me very confused. I recorded them out of order. That's all there is to it. All right. Suga brings the whole team to life. He really does. Like, and not just like when he first gets in there and he starts kind of attacking everybody in their own little ways and giving high fives and stuff like that. But like the way he talks to everybody, the plans that he makes, the aftermath of those plans, and like how he communicates with the rest of the team really brings the entire team to life. And I think that's awesome. Also, I like how much trouble Suki has responding to Suga when he's like, nice job, really good. And Suga's like, okay. Like, I love that Suki is just like, he doesn't know how to deal with it. And I said Suga a second ago, I meant to say Suki, but Tsukishima, he has a hard time kind of responding to that. I do have a third thing that I wanted to talk about, but it's not necessarily related to the episode. So I'm just going to leave that as is. I really, really enjoyed this episode just for the fact that, especially when I first watched it, because Suga's a really good setter. And I wanted him, like, as much as I like Kageyama, and I think he has some seriously good abilities, I wanted to see what Suga could do and what he's capable of, you know? And he is a third year, and he does have a lot of experience. And so, I definitely feel like I grew more attached to Suga as a character, and I was able to do more than just simply feel sorry for him. So I think this was a good episode for that. But I'm curious, what were your guys' thoughts and impressions? Like, how did this episode make you feel when you first started watching it? And did it raise your opinion of Suga in any way, shape, or form? All right, that's it. I'm going to go record episode 20 now because I recorded these out of order. But hey, I've already recorded Monday's episode. So there we go. Yeah, I made my decision. I'm going to stick with the 5 episodes a week, and next week will be the end of season 1. And hey, that means I only have to record 4 for next week. Awesome. All right, see you in episode 20. Later, Gators.